up, Lance Johnson.
Good morning, my fellow Republicans. I want to say, before I get too far down the trail, Merry Christmas to all of you. Christmas will be a part of my life and my term as governor. We also worship Easter with all you're going to enjoy in your life. Now, when I'm in the governor's office, you may come into my office and you may say a prayer. And I will say a prayer with you. I've learned this the hard way. I am beholden to God, and God has straightened me out a few times. There are a few times I didn't like the way he straightened me out. But ultimately, I did listen. So I am beholden to him, I am beholden to my wife, and I am beholden to my son Daniel, who is here today as well. So I want to say, first of all, before I came over here, I placed a call to the man who masquerades as one of our United States Senators, and that's Al Franken. I said, Al, do you have an explanation yet as to why you have been dealing inappropriately with women? He said no. He said it's still broken for an answer. So Franken needs a spanking. But I want to know, why isn't Amy Klobuchar giving you that spanking? Isn't she the great leader of women and women's rights? She said nothing. Does she condone this by her silence? Does she tacitly approve it? I know someone who will not tacitly approve it, and that's Jim Neuberger. So I hope you'll bear that in mind when you take into consideration whom you are going to support for the United States Senate. Now I want to divide my comments, which I have remaining, into three basic parts. Quickly, I'll tell you a little bit about myself, and then I'm going to talk about the legislative veto and the contest between Mark Dayton and our legislature. I have very strong and adamant views about how that should have been handled. Mr. Dean has already mentioned my hometown, and that's Umbrota. I moved there when I was 7 years old from Minneapolis. I wore knickers and played the piano. My little boys in Zimbabwe didn't either. So I was quickly laughed out of my knickers, literally, and stopped playing the piano. But I was bullied in school. I was bullied in grade school. I was not tall and lean like I am now. I was a little runt. I was called despicable names. They came to my home during my lunch hour and wanted money. One day I had no money, so I gave them my grandfather's gift to me, which was a pen and pencil set. Eventually I grew up, got a little taller, I played basketball, I set a defensive rebounding record, I was class president, and then eventually I went to McAllister College. And while at McAllister College, I was in a very, very serious car accident near Rochester, Minnesota. Bad car accident. My right foot, if you believe this, in 1958, was literally off, and they reattached it. I remember being in the operating room in St. Mary's Hospital. One person turned me and one person turned my foot, and they reattached it. I was in the hospital for 7 weeks, and finally I went home after dropping out of college. My father, who knew the law, he was one of the toughest guys in the world, never swore ever in his lifetime. But he told me, Lance, you think you're sitting around the house now? No, you're not. He took me down to Rochester. Enrolled me in the Rochester Junior College. He enrolled me in 22 credits. Normal load was 15 credits. He said, you have nothing better to do. Take the classes. When next fall comes around, you're going to be right on track at McAllister. And sure enough, I was. So my father would not take no for an answer. And now I want to talk a little bit about the veto. When he didn't veto that legislation, I'm a lawyer. Sometimes they call me a two-bit lawyer. And I don't know a lot about constitutional law, but I was pretty sure that the Republicans were on solid ground. And then, instead of picking a lawyer that was tough-minded, they called me up, I would give them a few. I saw that all of a sudden Mark Dayton was represented by Sam Hansen. Sam Hansen is a friend of mine. I've known him for 50 years. Actually, he and I had the same exact birthday, August 26th. And August 26th, 1939, was the first doubleheader on TV in New York. They played the Cincinnati Redlegs. They should have gone with a good lawyer. I was at the oral arguments at the Minnesota Supreme Court. When our lawyer, Kelly, stood up, I thought, this is all over. It's too late. We did lose. This case is not over. I have written to many members of the legislature. I do not hear back from them. And since I have only 1 minute left, I'm going to focus on this. The Republicans need to toughen up. You need to toughen up on this issue. Our legislature needs to fire Kelly, the lawyer representing us, and get a real constitutional lawyer. If they want one, have them call me. We'll find one. We'll spend $1 million or $2 million. But this is too important a constitutional question to let it lie. He is now said, come and sit me by me, like a little puppy. His dog is named Mingo. That's short for one Mingo. That's near Zambrero. So I know about all these towns. So it's time to toughen up. If you want a leader for governor, I am that person. The answer is in your hands. Thank you.